Hi you guys, this is Carmen with Losing It Together, and I have another delicious recipe. You know, one of the hardest things that some of us may have or some of us might face is what side dish to cook with our main dish. You know, a lot of times there's a lot of great dishes, but there's really not a lot of great side dishes, and this is one of my favorites. You can eat it alone. I eat it with eggs in the morning. It's just one of my favorites. You can eat it with, if you eat chips, you can eat it with like tostada chips, or better yet, if you make your own chips out of the whole wheat flatbreads or whole grain flatbreads, it's great. So what you'll need for this is, you're only going to need like a third of, if you have a huge onion like this, I'm just going to use a third of it. And you can use any onion you want. Onions are really great for you. I always try to incorporate them in all my dishes. I will list what they're good for because I sometimes tend to forget. But so I'm going to use a third of this. And it could be any onion. It could be a yellow onion, white onion, or a red onion. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use two bell peppers. Bell peppers are great for inflammation and everything, so I'm going to list the benefits on there. I'm also going to use half a bunch of cilantro. Probably, this is a big, you can use a jalapeño or you can use one of these serrano peppers. I'm only going to use half of it. And I'm going to use a big can of rinsed black beans and drained. This is a 27 ounce big can. Beans are really good for you if you want to do high fiber, lowers your cholesterol. It's also really good for your heart. It's also really good if you suffer with hemorrhoids. Plus, high fiber diets help you lose weight. It's just really, really good, and for your digestive system and everything. We're also going to be using lemon. I'm going to use about 1/3 to half a cup of lemon juice. Make sure it's 100% squeezed lemon. And I use some pepper to my liking. Some of us like more bell peppers than others, so use it to your discretion. Some of you guys might want it, might not. It's up to you. And the next thing is you can use is either sea salt or Himalayan pink salt. I use Himalayan pink salt because it has a lot of great benefits for your arteries. My husband's got heart problems, so this is why I use it. It's really good for you. I also use garlic. I try to make it as easy as possible so I can go ahead and cook my meals really fast. So I already buy the chopped or minced garlic. This is chopped. And I put about half a tablespoon to a tablespoon of garlic. So let's go ahead and get started. Make sure you chop your onion. I recently had to change the way I eat. I try to eat very healthy, more high fiber Mediterranean style. Mediterranean doesn't have to be like 100% Mediterranean. There's a lot of influences with Mediterranean dishes. Mine's more of a Spanish flair because I'm Hispanic, and I tend to like a lot of Hispanic flavors, a lot more spice. And so you can always change some of the Mediterranean cooking according to how you like it. If you, some of the recipes call for parsley, you don't like parsley, you can always use cilantro or whatever you like. For example, me, whenever it calls for parsley, I use a little bit of parsley and then cilantro. I'm not big parsley flake in certain recipes, so always try to go put what you like, what you know you would eat. So now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to incorporate my garlic, and this is good all on its own. It kind of reminds me of pico de gallo when I finish making it. So this is about a tablespoon, or just about. Put it in there. Of course, garlic's really good for you too. My son loves the way it smells. Our bell pepper is great for inflammation. If you, it has a lot of vitamin C, my daughter was telling me. There we go, and we're gonna chop it off. I hope this becomes your favorite salad like it is mine. Let's move this aside a little bit. Try to eat as healthy as you can. What ended up happening with me is I try to eat healthy all the time, but something happened to me that I'm forced now to eat healthy. My digestive system just can't handle whole flours, and sometimes you try to do your best, but sometimes your body's like, you know what? Thank you for trying your best, but it's not enough. So now your body reacts a certain way, and you're pretty much forced, which I don't mind. If somebody had told me, you know, I've tried so many diets, paleo, and I'm not knocking these out, because some of these work for a lot of people, and if it works for you, I've seen a lot of people lose a lot of weight with paleo. Who doesn't like meat, right? And but it was a little bit hard for me to do paleo, but at the end of the day, if you kind of think about it, a lot of the stuff is you have to eat whole natural foods, you have to eat fresh foods, nothing really that has been processed and made for you, and it's been sitting in the shelves, God knows for how long. I know I'm gonna use the beans. Most of the time, they all say it's okay if you use the beans or the tomatoes. They're, if you use the corn, but other than that, you don't want to eat like stews and things like that. So try to eat as many fresh foods as you can. But as I was saying, I've tried many diets, and I just recently went to the doctor. I had to go, it was an emergency, and she's like, Carmen, you just, you know, you can't be eating whole flours and stuff like that. You gotta eat a high fiber diet now. You can't be eating, you know, if you watch what you eat, your body, your digestive system, it needs more fiber. So you have to eat this way. Unless you want to have surgery, you have to be eating good. And I'm like, oh, I don't want surgery. I have to eat good. So that's where my body's basically telling me, you know, you got to take care of me. If you don't, you have to have surgery. And I thought I was doing good, but my body's like, no white flour. I think I had eaten white flour, and I got very sick. So now I know I can't. And it was so painful for me that I'm like, I don't want to go through that again. I don't want to experience that pain again. So it's got to be high fiber, whole grains, as I can. And when she said high fiber, it just seemed much easier for me than they say, okay, you can't eat this, you can't eat that, you can't touch this, you can't touch that, you cannot have, you know, a lot of times it's like, you can't. And so you're like, oh my God, I can't eat this, this is that. But when she said, just change everything you've been eating to whole grains, and or everything on high fiber, whole grains, whole wheat, high fiber, and it was just easier for me because it felt like I wasn't being deprived of certain things, and that just, it's just been really easy for me. I lost I want to say 8 pounds within a week and a half. So because I ended up I don't know how these little hairs get in there. I ended up gaining a little bit of weight because I'm prone to injuries. I'm always getting injured, and I injured my leg really bad and I couldn't move it. So anyway, I gained some weight. So I'm trying to lose weight again, and this kind of revamped my, I've always been big about nutrition and trying to eat right. And so this revamped me, and I was like, you know what? I've been thinking about it, going back to my channel. I've been thinking about eating healthy and just doing everything. And I do love the Mediterranean. She said, you're doing Mediterranean? That's the best, one of the best diets to follow besides the American Heart Association, and they're both high in high fiber and whole grains. That's perfect for you. So now I've revamped my channel, and so I'm going to start everything all over again. And some of us, you know, we lose weight, we gain weight, we get injured, we gain weight. It turns out I dislocated my shoulder twice. I hurt my leg really bad. It was hard for me to walk. It was just, and it went all the way up to my, my sciatic, you know. I injured my leg, and then it ended up affecting my whole sciatic area and my whole back. And finally, I'm starting to feel better again, and I'm starting to do more exercises again. So I'm really excited. And so I went ahead and put half a bunch of cilantro. I put the two bell peppers and the cilantro along with that. And then now I'm going to chop my jalapeno, well, my serrano pepper. I'm only going to do half, because she also told me I can't be eating a lot of peppers, and that's really hard for me because I'm Hispanic, not eating peppers. One time I made a joke with my daughter, well, we like eating jalapenos, mama, why you love jalapenos? And she said, no, why, mom, why do I love jalapenos? And I said, because instead of giving you a pacifier as a baby, I used to give you a jalapeno. So you are used to it. That's my dog. And she's like, oh my God. But I was just kidding with her. But yeah, I grew up eating a lot of spicy food, going to Mexico and eating all that good stuff. So, but she told me I can't be eating it that way anymore. Anyway, so I'm going to tone it down on my spiciness, but you guys can always add more. So if you know you can handle your spiciness, get a whole one. So I'm just putting half of one. We're going to put that in there. And put it in there. I've also changed my workout because, as I told you, I got injured and I had to be careful. And I've been doing the bar method. Oh my God, I love that workout. I highly recommend it. I'll do a review, but I can tell the difference. I love bar workouts. So now we're also going to put our black beans in there. Put them in there, nice and rinsed. Plus, they have a lot of fiber, and that's what she says I have to eat from now on. Please, you know, go as you would like putting the salt in there. I'm just going to put it's probably like half a teaspoon of salt in there. and put some pepper, like about a quarter of a teaspoon of fresh ground pepper. And I'm going to put about a third to half a cup of lemon juice. Yum. I love lemon juice. Lemon is really, really good for you. Make sure you drink water after you're done, because the acidity, the teeth, every time I have a cold or a runny nose or my throat hurts, I warm up a little tea with honey and lemon. I put a little bit of honey, about a quarter cup of honey, put it in. This is for the tea, for your throat. And nuke it for about 6 seconds. And then put about a tablespoon of lemon and mix it up. And you can drink it as many times as your throat gets irritated. And it really helps with your sore throat and phlegm and all that stuff. So now that I mixed it, let me try it a little bit. Always taste your food. If you think it needs a little bit more salt, put a little bit more salt. Don't overdo it, because if you overdo the salt, you can't take it away. And if you're putting little by little, you can always add a little bit more if you need some more. So same thing with the pepper. So we still take it easy. And so let me see how it tastes. Oh my God, it's really good. Perfect. And so now my suggestion is that you put it in the fridge for about, they say about an hour to half an hour. What I do is I put it in the freezer for 15 minutes and then I eat it. It gets it cold right away. So you can just eat it all by yourself. Like, this is a great vegetarian dish, or you can use it as a side dish. So my son wants chicken, so I'm going to make him some chicken, and he loves couscous, which is part of the Mediterranean from Africa. And so I like, I give him some couscous with chicken and a lot of the salad. We love it. It's delicious. I might have a little bit of couscous, maybe like a tablespoon, and mainly the salad. And in the mornings, what I do is I'll make me one egg on top of this with a little bit of avocado. I am going to add, so feel free to add like little, a little bit of avocado. Avocado is really good. It's got the good fats that are really good for you. And so I highly recommend that you at least try to eat an avocado a day. That's really good for you. And it has a lot of fiber. And so thank you guys so much. And don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. And well, I'm making more videos. I'm back on it again. I really feel, you know, me getting sick and having to go to the hospital and everything, it's really revamped me. And I was doing good, but this revamped me to like take it 100% serious, because I, like a lot of us, you know, I have no choice now. This is the way I have to eat now. And I was trying my best. I worked a couple times where I had a cheat day. And so that one day that I got the cheat day and I ate pizza, I got really sick with the white flour. And she said, you cannot be eating white flour, because I'd been eating Mediterranean as much as I could. I was eating Mediterranean diet. So, but now that, once she said, eat a high fiber diet, you can still eat this, blah, 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 blah. Just as long as it's whole grains and whole wheat, you're okay. And so I'm going to combine everything I know from the Mediterranean inspired dishes with the whole grains and incorporate them and share them with you guys, okay? So thank you so much. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. Take care, you guys. Bye.